Thank you so much for joining us for this year's Founders Award. We're used to hosting this event in person, but we are thrilled that you're joining us virtually from all around the world. Everyone has been significantly impacted by the pandemic, and MoPOP is no exception. Our mission of creating community around the universal language of pop culture has helped bring people together in these trying times. Tonight is a great example of this.
Founders Award is a very special evening for us. This event is the time of the year where we raise the highest amount of donations to support our programs. We really hope that you'll take the opportunity to donate to help support our educational outreach, our youth initiatives, and our amazing exhibits. It's been a tough year for MoPOP, but let's face it, it's been a tough year for everyone. Through your donations, we can continue to impact people's lives through the world of pop culture. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. We hope that you all continue to stay safe and stay healthy and enjoy the rest of the program. Thanks for supporting MoPOP.
I'm so honored and humbled to play in this place and play for such a cognizant audience, an audience that knows the value of creativity and is willing to fight to bring it to a generation.
Jimi Hendrix Museum!
I gotta thank him, man. Hendrix is the reason I even started picking up the guitar.
Like between Hendrix to Eddie Van Halen, 10 years. That's all.
It's incredible how fast it was moving, man.
Back when we were all living in the band house, we'd all pile into a car and go drive out to Jimmy's grave because people would always leave joints on his headstone.
Oh, shit.
Remember that, Sean?
We'd gather up all the like roaches and like some guitar picks and fucking dry them out.
Angel, where you gonna run to now? Angel, where you gonna run to now?
My cousin moved in with my mother and me and brought the band to Gypsy's record. And the minute I heard that, I was hooked. And I didn't even know what he looked like at first. We didn't have any pictures. Started peppering my cousin with all kinds of questions about how is he doing all that with a guitar. He went to the library and got some photocopies of old Rolling Stone magazines. I saw he looked like us. That was just a bonus, and that was it for me, man. I was hooked for life. The museum kind of being built around his legacy, and this whole Sky Church thing, it's awesome, and no one could deserve it more. And thanks to Hendrix, and thanks to Paul Allen, and thanks to Seattle, you know, we're honored to be a part of it.
It's pretty cool to have so many of our friends doing tunes, man.
Hey everyone, I'm Jacob McMurray, Director of Curatorial Collections and Exhibits for Seattle's Museum of Pop Culture. From 1987 to today, Alice in Chains has sold over 30 million records. They kickstarted the grunge explosion, and they're undeniably one of the most influential American rock bands of all time. Now, 2020 is a big year. It's the 20th anniversary of our institution, MoPOP, but it's also the 30th anniversary of Alice in Chains' debut album, Facelift, which was the first album of the grunge era to go gold. And from Facelift to 2018's Rain or Fog and beyond, Alice in Chains continues to explore new sonic territories and inspire legions of fans worldwide. So tonight, we're incredibly excited to honor our hometown heroes with the 2020 Museum of Pop Culture Founders Award, along with an epic tribute concert featuring rock legends, musical guests, and Alice in Chains.
Come on, buddy. It's okay. It's okay. Oh, yeah. Just walk with me. How you doing? You look like you're a little new to this town.
Yeah, I think my guitar is out of tune.
All right, hang on again.
Thank you.
it's over.
Hi, everybody. I'm Nona Weissbaum. I just want to congratulate my Seattle rock boys, Alice in Chains, for being honored with the Founders Award from the MoPOP Museum in Seattle, Washington. Many years ago, I came to town and was trying to write a story I submitted to Redbook and Sassy, but was denied. But I kept up a relationship with the boys, and I kept an eye on them from afar. So it's nice to see them get this sort of an honor. Anyway, it's going to be a fantastic concert. Please donate. Hit the donate button. Enjoy Alice in Chains and their friends playing all their music, and it's going to be a big hootenanny of love.
Hey, this is Mike McCready from Pearl Jam, or from Mookie Blaylock when we opened up for you, Alice in Chains, way back in the day up in Vancouver or some crazy stuff like that. Congratulations, Jerry and Sean and Mike and William. Thank you for rocking the world for so long. And all right, you guys are awesome. Love you. Congratulations again on the MoPOP Founders Award.
Snuff the rooster.
send me pictures of my boy.
Sammy Hagar here. I'm congratulating the Museum of Pop Culture from Seattle on their inductee this year, Alice in Chains. Congratulations. You guys got it right. Homeboys, badass mofos. I love these guys. They deserve it. God bless you guys. Congratulations. Peace. Very, very cool to be honored in your hometown. It's the best place.
That's nice, man.
Electric wow. Ladyland. I got the Ladyland console.
We mix the unplugged record at Electric Ladyland.
Yeah. That's a necklace right there.
Seattle zone, man.
The Woodstock guitar.
The Woodstock. Yeah, some sorcery was done on that thing.
Look, it's just so cool that it's like his hands were on it. Wow, look at his frets too. They're kind of the square ones, huh?
But we got Confusion, we got Universal Gypsy Queen.
Is that his writing?
I'm gonna guess it.
Oh,
probably.
June 4th, 67,
yeah,
right there.
Yeah, he probably self-painted this thing and probably wrote on it himself. Do what you know, practice what you preach. Yeah, man. Amen.
I just think it's really cool, man. I mean, growing up here, you know, we had a handful of artists to kind of call our own. Knowing that Jimmy was here and, you know, a handful of others like Hart and Queensryche, and before we got going, it was just like a signpost of that it was possible that you could actually do that, you know, and it was some of the best music that was ever made. And to be here in our hometown and to be in this building with all this great music history, it's amazing that Paul did this, you know, put this all together, and his love for music and you know, being a part of honoring other artists. For us to be the artists now is a trip, man. I mean, it's really meaningful, and you know, it just feels really good.
Thank you.
started, you know, basically as an idea to do something to really commemorate and celebrate a particular artist, but now it's broadened. So it's a lot more about showing people they can get in and make their own music. My background, obviously, you know, being one of the founders of Microsoft, and even before that, has been in the technology area. So I thought that it would be great to use the technology to push the architecture and then try to get the aspect of involving people's creativity and showing them how they can become creative into one concept in a way that hadn't been done before.
So our goal was to be as broad as possible in designing what those experiences could be and what they could mean for the visitor, and to make the content accessible to the widest possible range of people.
We are encouraging a type of thinking about things that people already have familiarity with, and to really get them connecting with one another about issues and ideas that are embedded in this content in a new way. And I think that makes for a really potentially transformative experience for museum goers.
It's so much more than sharing memorabilia. It's sharing that anything is possible. Here's an example of these people that did it. You can too.
Paul Allen and Jody Allen founded the museum, inspired in part by their mother, who always made sure they had opportunities to explore new things. The idea was to create a place that brings hands-on creativity to people, a place where anyone can pick up a musical instrument for the very first time, or see themselves as the next big science fiction writer, or imagine being an indie game developer.
One of my theories about the museum is if you can inspire the Jimi Hendrixes or the Eric Claptons or other people like that of the future, that'll have made it all worthwhile.
Hello, I miss you all. I can't wait to see you again. My name is Megan Jasper and I work over at Sub Pop Records. Welcome to the 2020 Founders Award. I'd like to take a minute to share a massive congratulations to Alice in Chains and to MoPOP for what will be a great evening of music. I support MoPOP because it plays an important role in the telling of history and music from the Northwest and around the world. This year has been so hard, so difficult. There are parts of our industry that are hurting so badly, and so it's crucial right now to make donations that support arts and music. So if you are able, please consider making a donation tonight to MoPOP. Thank you so much for all you do, and I hope you have a great evening. Thank you.
Hey, what's up? This is Dave Navarro, and I just want to say thank you to MoPOP for preserving music and pop culture.
MoPOP, thank you. You guys are rad, and it's killer that you guys are honoring Alice in Chains, because they're rad too. I'm Taylor Hawkins.
Right?
Ave Maria.
I'm spazzing so hard. We played these songs earlier today, and we're all laid back, and then the camera's on.
It always happens, dude.
Perry. Hey, Perry.
I gotta tell you, man.
Did you see how he's in the shower?
You see that Dr. Dan?
Save me.
How you doing? Nice to see you. Thanks for tuning in to MoPOP's Founders Award. I'd like to extend a laurel and hearty handshake to this year's winner, Allison Chains. Unfortunately, given the circumstances of this terrible year, a decent laurel is hard to find, so the hearty handshake will have to do. Thanks to MoPOP for making this happen, for pulling it together. In case you don't know about MoPOP, if you don't live in the Seattle area, MoPOP is a museum that focuses on the history of music and pop culture around the world. And of course, like all museums, it's struggling in these times. So if you can, please donate. Thank you.
I think the nostalgia is what kind of attracted me initially. But since then, my love for MoPOP has kind of evolved. You guys do a great job celebrating and recognizing artists and musicians of the past and the present. But you guys are also very strong advocates for artists and musicians of the future.
Just knowing how many youth programs and access programs are available.
To get the kids involved in terms of music, art, theater, to really bring pop culture home to the community.
Supporting programs and projects like Sound Off and the residency and the sci-fi writing competition.
You guys take the arts to the students of Seattle who may not have an opportunity or access.
I have a daughter that plays piano and another one that takes ballet, and I like to take them here to kind of show them what they can do as they continue to grow with their particular art fields.
Kids are gonna see this and go, my wildest dreams can come true.
I don't view you as just a voice for the community, but as the stage for the community. You guys help these future artists and musicians find the voice for themselves and give them the platform to be able to express themselves. And I wanna see MoPOP continue to do that in the community for the next 20 years.
I just wanna say something. I had the honor of playing with these gentlemen here for the last couple shows, and this is something that's bigger than all of us, and it was a really brave decision for these guys to come out here and do this, and you fucking fans showing up for support, fucking awesome motherfucking Chains, and William Duvall, Allison Chains is fucking back, don't forget.
We'll be right back. The thing that I love about MoPOP is that we think out of the box. The exhibits that we come up with about pop culture, there's something there for everyone. Whether it's Minecraft or whether it's Hello Kitty, or my favorite has been the Star Trek exhibit because I'm a huge sci-fi fan, and the music.
I'm in it for the music.
The music?
Music too, obviously.
I just love the way the exhibits keep changing. And in terms of just how it connects to the community, it's really both the community locally in Seattle, as well as how we've attracted a worldwide audience in both our architecture that attracts people initially, then they come in here and they're just wowed by all the exhibits.
We have other museums, but none of them really reach such a wide audience as this one does. I feel like just anybody of any age could come here and they would have a good time.
Honestly, I think if you've ever watched TV or a movie in the last, 70 years, there's something here that you're gonna love.
Pop culture is such a pervasive phenomenon. We're all taking it in a lot of the time, and for most of us, it's a source of great enjoyment and relaxation and thinking and connecting with other people.
You know, I think the reason why it's so important is because there's always people who are curious and who want to learn, and having an environment that has a blend of curiosity, that has a blending of learning, that has a blending of history, is something that's always going to be in demand for people to go and explore and experience.
If you want kids like me to be able to join the art community in Seattle, learn how to play instruments, get involved, educate themselves, MoPOP needs to be here. So if you want it to stay alive as a nonprofit as it is, offering these amazing programs and events and exhibits, donate now.
I feel mystical and magical in here. I kind of feel like a Dungeons and Dragons game is going to bust out any second. This is the helmet that he wore when he farted in your general direction.
Your mother was a hamster, and your father smelt of elderberries.
This is Richie Blackmore's original hat from Deep Purple. This is the one that he wore when he wrote Smoke on the Water, and when he played it on stage, this is the one he preferred. You know, I mean, that's admittedly not a flattering picture of Richie Blackmore, but big deal right there, big deal.
I don't think this is the role playing I'm thinking of.
That is the Magna Carta, the original Magna Carta right there.
I never really got what the big deal was with this whole Harry Potter thing. Never really clicked with me. Maybe I was too old by the time it came out, but it never really did anything for me.
We'll be right back.
drifting body, its soul desertion. Flying, not yet quite the notion.
Congratulations to Alice in Chains on being this year's Founders Award winners. And thank you, MoPOP, for putting together this awesome tribute. I'm so excited to be part of it. MoPOP is a great, unique, quirky Seattle legend in its own right. If you are enjoying tonight's concert, please consider donating to MoPOP to help keep them going strong and keeping quirky for years to come. Thank you.
I can barely see your face. Wonder how that color tastes.
Music and I love culture. I've spent my life playing music, being part of arts and culture in the city. I just see what MoPOP can do for the community and what the dream was of placing it here in the middle of the Seattle center. I see it as very much of an expression and celebration of the human curiosity and creativity. And I think the more our young people get to experience things that go on here, the more they see a path for themselves. I think any artist, you know, who comes through here feels empowered.
MoPOP is an independent nonprofit. We have been in existence since the year 2000, so this is our 20th anniversary celebration. Walk into the fantasy exhibit and you can see these young kids who have connected with Harry Potter, and you see these objects that are right there in front of them and their eyes light up, and it's absolutely magical. It doesn't matter what walk of life you come from, you can connect to some form of pop culture. Now with the pandemic, it's created an opportunity for us to develop our online content so that we're able to connect with people all over the world. So whether you're into music, film, or any sort of pop culture genre, or just supporting kids in their development, partner with us. Your donation will allow us to not only keep the doors open, but allow us to expand more opportunities for people all over the world, particularly young people.
Missed it by that much.
Ready?
Last one. Let's do this. One more time.
Sunset, we're born into the grave.
I like the section of the museum where kids can actually get their hands on instruments and mess around and play and interact with it. It's pretty great.
I brought my son here and he did exactly that.
Yeah, it's pretty great.
We went into the booths and jammed, man. Yeah. It was killer. Yeah. Yeah, I brought my boy here. We recorded Rain or Fog here in Seattle. So my boy came out to visit and we brought him here. He would have been about 7 or 8. And we went into that booth there, I believe, and ended up playing I think it was Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg. We were playing Nothing But a G Thing. And it was great, man, because my girlfriend at the time, my wife now, she was kind of rapping, and I taught Marshall the little keyboard line that na 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 na. It was good times. So I love that there's a facility like this in any city, you know? We need more of this, but I'm glad this one's here, and long may it rain.
Ah, some scorpions.
In any facility where a child can come and get their hands on instruments, and jam and have fun, and particularly when they can do it in an interactive way with other people, that's just a treasure. It's a treasure, and I don't know where I would have been had I not had the opportunity as a kid to start learning to play an instrument, and then very soon after I first picked up that instrument, play with other cats. And I wouldn't be standing where I am now without that. Everyone in Seattle should be grateful for this place.
Sound Off is our annual 21 and under music showcase and competition.
The level of talent that's out there is amazing. We are able to create a community for that talent.
It is somebody handing you a Willy Wonka's golden ticket and saying, we're gonna take you seriously, we're gonna put you on a big stage, and we're gonna give you a platform.
It was like a big introduction to the world.
Some of them have never performed outside of a talent show. Some of them have never performed outside of their bedrooms.
It can be really nerve-wracking being vulnerable enough to share your art. I want it to last forever.
I want it to last forever. I think it steered us in a direction of being a lot more confident in our own sound because we got recognition for it and someone believed in us.
What they get out of it is an opportunity to be in this room together and to recognize their collective power.
It's so different to be able to come around other young people your age, people who look like you, people who think the way that you do.
We still talk about all the bands we want to take with us when we go on our tour someday.
Yep.
And they're all Sound Off people, and we love them so much.
That's where collaborations come from. You get to start other bands with other people.
Start vibing.
A lot of the members who have come through this program have continued to be active in the music scene and continue to come back and mentor in showing them what it means to be an invested member of this community.
So much like creative diversity that goes on here, and it's a reflection of the people.
It's gonna be the thing that carries us, that we can look back on and say, this is our story, this is what happened to us, this is what we lived through, what we survived through.
We've impacted each other. That's been really powerful to have that.
It's just really been amazing to see these people finding comfort in each other in this time when it is so hard.
I've been blessed enough to find other people who care about music, and that's what programs like this do. It's just, give kids hope.
I'm
it might seem an afterthought. Yes, it hurts to know you're blind. It's your decision. It's your decision to feed the fire that burned us all when you lied, to feel the pain that spurs you on back inside.
When the pandemic forced us to close our doors in March, we had to completely reinvent how to deliver on our mission. We tapped into the creative spirit that we celebrate at the museum and experimented with different ways to engage our audiences. We started film watch-alongs and online book clubs. We created educational materials that parents could use with kids who couldn't go to school, and we even held a Minecraft-themed summer camp online. While the pandemic was keeping us apart, we were determined to use pop culture to bring us together. At the end of the summer, things were looking up, and we were thrilled to welcome guests back in person. We invested in modifications to make sure people could have a safe visit to the museum, and even started experimenting with how to give guests a completely touchless experience. But with cases spiking, we've had to shutter the museum once again, making support from the community even more important. Our future is uncertain, so any contribution you can make to ensure that our programs that reach young people can continue is so very much appreciated.
It's gonna rain. Was it something I said held against me? Ain't no life on the run, slowly climbing. Caught in light, so she stares, stares at nothing. I can't help her but won't. Now she hates me. Did she call my name? I think it's gonna rain. Oh, when I
occasion, Founders Award, you deserve the recognition. Also, one thing I have to thank you for is all those years ago, there was a band that had five guys in it, they had 10 songs, and they didn't even have a band name. And you took us on the road with us, and we went on our first tour. So thank you for that. Thank you for taking Mookie Blaylock on the road with you. Those early tours, those are the ones you'll never forget. So I wanted to thank you for the music. Thank you for your resilience. And I just want to say that it's about time that you are now institutionalized. Okay. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Feeling alright. Jerry, come on. Sean, Mike, William, Alice in Chains. It's the one band everyone can still agree upon. How did you do it? 33 years later, I'll tell you. Unadulterated, iconic, understatement, superstars who never sold out. That's the trifecta. Dark, luxurious harmonies, lyrics that make you think and feel. It's the SEM, baby. Seriously elevated musicianship. I cannot wait to see and hear what you do next. I congratulate you, one and all, past and present. Lane and Mike would be so proud of this legacy. Your profound contribution, in my opinion, is you have saved the planet from mediocrity. Yep. Like, oh my God, that'd be a great superhero villain. Mediocritus. Mediocritus, you are vanquished and banished forevermore in the name of AIC.
Hey everyone, we are Stone Temple Pilots, and we just wanted to send out a huge congratulations to Alice in Chains for getting inducted into the Museum of Pop Culture. We love you guys very much.
Congratulations, guys.
Congratulations. Love you.
Yeah, we love you guys dearly.
Hi, I'm Tom Morello. I'd like to wish a congratulations to my good friends in Alice in Chains on this well-deserved award. Alice in Chains is one of the greatest rocking bands of the last three decades, in part because they unapologetically combined their heavy metal heritage with profoundly deep underground artistry and haunting music and poetry that will resonate through the ages. The first time I saw Alice in Chains, they were opening up for Extreme at a small Orange County club. During their opening set, I was the only one in the front row and probably the only one there that really had a clue what the fuck was going on. And they blew my mind and been blowing my mind ever since. The first time I met them, though, was at Lollapalooza in 1993. Alice in Chains were headlining and Rage Against the Machine were opening. We were newbies on the touring scene and they welcomed us with open arms and also welcomed us with a very weird gift in the dressing room. It was like this gift box that someone went to the 99-cent store and bought one of every crazy thing. There were like spatulas and gum and Gumby and Pokey dolls and whatever was there, but that really welcomed us and we became good friends. I spent a lot of time laughing with Lane, arguing which of us was more metal. At the end of the day, it was perhaps him, though I'm still trying. Jerry has been a great friend through the years, and whenever I've asked him to play at any benefit concert, he's one of the first to always say yes. It's been great jamming with him. I admit that when the new version of Alice in Chains announced that they were debuting at the Roxy, that I was somewhat skeptical, and I went as a fan with fingers crossed, and they blew my fucking mind. It had every bit of the power and the awesomeness and the depth of all of my favorite Alice in Chains shows of the past. So congratulations to all the members of Alice in Chains, and keep that rocking alive, and next time I see you, we'll decide once and for all who is most metal.
Thank you.
number 13 to come in here. This isn't for everybody. This isn't for everybody.
Getting assaulted by the lighting rig.
I think these people are all mad because nobody liked their photo of their salad on Instagram.
6 hours, three likes.
No, I posted it and waited.
Wasted effort.
6 hours.
There's scary noises.
Whoa, sacks of meat.
Looks like my uncle's basement. That's Jerry in the morning before his first coffee.
That's a rough wake up right there.
Oh, this place is rocking. Last time I took this tour, it was just all music. You know?
It's all music?
All music, yeah. I've never seen that since.
All music. They're diversifying their holdings, man.
You should have Cobain's sweater upstairs in the music section, shouldn't you?
Gonna say, kinda weird. I think Kurt deserves better.
That doesn't look like his signature there either. Kids, it's generally not a good idea to have sharp kitchen cutlery in that kind of zone. Oh, it's the Evil Dead 2.
I swallow your soul. I swallow your soul.
This is the camera they use on Blair Witch Project.
Oh, is that the camera?
Yeah. Wow, 1954, Creature from the Black Lagoon. I love horror stuff, though. This is awesome. I like Mom.
Got Jason right here.
I think that's a goalie or the Sabres.
Oh, hey now. All right. Larry, is that you? God, is it? Wow.
If you have kids in the room, just get them out. Scariest thing in here. So, kids gone? Everybody gone? Okay, only adults? Let's do this.
Hey guys, it's Cameron here saying bravo and congratulations to Alice in Chains for your incredible honor as part of MoPOP's 20th anniversary and the 30th anniversary of Facelift. As one of your early directors, I just want to say I take this in a very emotional way, and it means a lot to me that you mean so much to us. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.
pop culture really does span generations. It's not only nostalgia and preserving what's happened, but it's also the right here and right now. So Paul Allen had this incredible collection that he wanted to share with the world. And from that, we've been able to build upon it to be able to continue that legacy in sharing it with the broader community at large. We have like over 100,000 artifacts, which is so incredible. There's just a lot of really neat things here. We want to make sure that we are capturing the here and the now, and that we're always working towards preservation so that we can share that power of pop culture to really inspire that next generation of creators and to really bridge connection and community.
Charles Peterson here, coming at you from what I like to call the grunge mine. I hope you're having fun at the 2020 MoPOP Founders Awards featuring Alice in Chains. I've been honored and grateful to work with MoPOP over the years, and if you would like to ensure that artists such as myself continue to present their archives, please get whatever you can in whatever amount. Anything helps. I hope to see you again in the museum someday soon.
Yeah.
Claypool, and I'm here to congratulate my pals in Alice in Chains for receiving the MoPOP Founders Award. So...
Congratulations to Alice in Chains. Congratulations to MoPOP for this amazing evening of music. If you're enjoying any of what you're seeing, you might consider donating to MoPOP to help keep it going. The arts and museums have taken a huge hit this year, and any gift you make will make sure the awesome concerts like tonight will keep going well into the future, and MoPOP can continue telling the story of pop culture for generations.
Hi, I'm Susan Silver, and I've had the pleasure of managing Alice in Chains since 1988. I'm so proud of the guys. This Founders Award is well deserved. The band and I have seen the world together, celebrated many successes and mourned too many losses, including two of the original members of this band, Lane Staley and Mike Starr. After the 2004 tsunami hit Southeast Asia, the three remaining members came back together for a benefit to help the survivors. Their performance reignited their passion and purpose to be Alice in Chains. In 2005, they invited William Duvall into the band, and they toured tirelessly for the next 3 years while new music of reclamation and healing brewed up inside them. In 2009, they released their first record since 1995, and that record and its title track are called Black Gives Way to Blue. When the record was finished, my then 9-year-old daughter Lily asked me, "Mama, what does Black Gives Way to Blue mean?" I suggested we call her Uncle Jerry and ask him. Jerry ever so patiently explained to Lily that sometimes there are very dark and challenging times in life, and it may seem like things will never get better. But if you stay strong and keep moving forward and look out on the horizon, you'll start to see a little point of light way out there, and slowly the black would give way to blue. He told her things would start to feel better, and for her to hold on to hope and keep moving forward toward that light. Lily and I have kept this message close to our hearts. Lily has known her crazy uncles and Alice in Chains all of her 20 years. And tonight, 11 years after that call to Jerry, the band has invited her to make her musical debut, accompanied by one of her less crazy uncles, Chris DeGarmo of Queensryche. For me, this is one of life's most beautiful full circles. So it is with deep pride and gratitude that I introduce my daughter, Lily Cornell Silver. Take it away, baby.
I don't wanna feel no one.
Hey guys, it's your new-ish friend, Josh, here. One of the best things about being in the Chili Peppers for 10 years is having the ability to, or being able to express to people like you how much you mean to me and how much you mean to the entire world and how amazing your contribution has been and how honored I am to have met you, befriended you, and made some noise with you. So congratulations for everything, and I wish all of you, Mike, Lane, William, Mike, Sean, and Jerry, all the best and lots of love from a devoted, devoted fan.
I hope that all of us can find a way to contribute to the good work that happens at MoPOP and reach deep in our pockets and throw in a bit to help them get through these tough times we're all in. You can do it. I can do it. We can all do it. Thanks, everyone.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. We're the Cornell family, and we're here to congratulate Alice in Chains on their wonderful award. Good going, guys.
Congrats, guys.
Congratulations, Alice.
Congratulations, you guys, on your Founders Award from MoPOP. You deserve it. Thank you so much for all the music, all these 30 years. And thank you for the inspiration. I love you guys. You're my brothers. Congratulations. Love you.
Alice in Chains facelift 30-year anniversary. I am so excited that MoPOP chose Alice in Chains. I love the fact that we get to share this moment with you guys and that MoPOP is honoring you with the Founders Award.
The reason that I have whiplash injuries and migraines is because of Man in the Box. I still do it.
Me too.
Whenever that song comes on.
I recently came across the live video of the facelift record being performed at the Moor. And I had driven Chris to that show that night, and we picked up this little hippie kid on the way who was going to be playing in the opening band, a band called Mookie Blaylock. And this kid's name was Ed Vedder. And we picked him up on the way to the show. And then Chris was going to sit in, and he sat in and did a couple of Temple of the Dog songs with the guys, because Jeff and Stone were in Mookie. And then Alice came out.
The first time I remember meeting any of them was down at Seattle Center. And they were with Susan, two of the guys, I think it was Jerry and Sean, we were sitting outside by the fountain. And I was introduced to them. So this was a very long time ago when they were very young. So seeing them come up through all these years and be this successful is pretty fun. And I'm really proud of them.
Yeah.
of a place to end up from. Oh yeah, California, I'm fine. Somebody check my brain. California, alright. Somebody check. She sang, I answered the call. Oh yeah, California, I'm fine. Somebody check my brain. California, alright. Somebody check.
Congratulations, fellas, on the Founders Award. 30 plus years of persistence and hard work has created a truly influential and original niche in the world rock and roll scene. I have many fond memories of hanging out with you guys. Before going over to see a show at the Mural Amphitheater, maybe My Sister's Machine or Bath of Gin or SGM, one of the other great Seattle bands. I miss you, Lane. I miss you, Mike, Demery. Congratulations, Jerry, Sean, Mike, William, and Susan. Much love. See you soon.
One, two, three, four. Thank you.
Hey, buddies. Congratulations on the Mopar Auto Parts Band of the Year. Just kidding. I think it's MoPOP. Congratulations on the MoPOP Founders Award. Hey, we're glad to be a part of your journey in life, and really cool to have got to know all you guys and to tour with you guys and play music with you guys. So you are much appreciated, and thank you for continuing on playing music and offering some inspiration for the new musicians of the world.
Boys, fellas, brothers, I'll second everything that James just said. You guys are a true inspiration. Thank you for being brothers in arms, friends in arms. So what are we coming up on 30 years here? Much love to all of you from San Francisco.
Hi, my name is Vernon Reed from the band Living Color, and I want to give a quick shout out to my dudes, Alice in Chains, one of my favorite bands on the planet. Congratulations for winning the Museum of Pop Culture's 2020 Founders Award. Y'all have been through hell and kept on rocking, and I love y'all. Peace.
Guitar Galley.
Sister Rosetta. Peter Green, that's cool.
There it is, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Does that thing still work? Or?
Works fine. I just recorded with it. Blue Dress, that's my original D&L there. I bought that in 1985. That guitar has been on everything I've ever recorded, pretty much. 98.9% of every song that you've ever heard, that guitar is on there somewhere.
And I tried for decades to wreck it, and it still exists. I've stood on it, surfed it across the stage, jumped in the audience with it.
Like fans running up, getting their hair caught in the keys, and then trying to jump back in the audience, pulling me with them. The design on it I did out of, you can see we have our local rock station who was really instrumental in supporting the band before anybody else in this town. Used to play our demo tapes, KISW. And so the rock stickers I got there, and also the circle and square was the kind of, you know, the frame of the sticker itself. I was inspired by Eddie Van Halen, the stripe pattern of his, and I also was a fan of Randy Rhoads, how he had the polka dots, and so I thought it was cool to have some sort of a homemade design that was you know. So I just kind of made that circle and square pattern, put the rock stickers on there, and then
because that's what you were doing on it, rocking.
Yeah, and then yanked a pinup girl out of a porn mag and put her on the tail there. Got a Soundgarden sticker on the back. Another band called Son of Man.
What's that from? This Is Your Life.
Yeah, This Is Your Life. I made a decision to do this and to get good and learn how to play and write tunes and stuff. And so that was a reminder to myself, that's your life. And it is. There's so much sweat and grime and beer and you name it on that guitar, and you can see it. More than a few guitar techs were like, let me clean that up for you. I'm like, don't fucking touch it, man. Leave the dirt on it, you know? The blood stays on the blade.
Hi, you guys, it's Davey here from Elton's band. We're good friends for many years now, and I have to congratulate you guys on your lifetime achievement. I guess it's the Founders Award? Wow, unbelievable. Alice in Chains, one of my favorite bands, and Facelift, 30 years, is it really 30 years already? Unbelievable, one of my favorite albums back then too. And I had a listen the other day, and you guys rock. From then till now, you never stopped rocking, in fact. I know you guys have been through a lot, like all bands have, a lot of tragedy in your life and within your band, and you're still there rocking away, and God bless you for that, because we need you badly on this scene. Jerry, I've known you for so many years now, it seems, and I'm so proud of you, man. I love the fact that you did one of our songs way back as well. You did a version of Curtains that we loved. And Mike, what can I say? We see each other probably in a few hours. See you in a meeting. Love you to death, you guys, and give my best to William and the other guys in the band. And big congratulations. And love from Elton, too. Thanks.
We get awards too.
We got some awards.
Wow,
that's pretty amazing.
Alrighty, cool.
I hope you guys enjoyed yourselves. We certainly did. Being a part of the evening, I was just thinking, this band started 33 years ago, 3.5 miles down the road in Ballard, and pretty amazing journey that we're still on, and. I'd like to thank Jody Allen and the MoPOP board and Leslie Chihuly, the Founders Award Committee as well. Jacob, Brooke, Andrew, the museum staff, the crew, everybody here who's made this possible. And, you know, we'd like to really take a moment and think about the vision and, you know, the love of music that Paul Allen had. And it's amazing to be sitting here and to see that tradition continuing too. You know, and God, there's so many great artists that are, you know, friends that contributed shout outs and performances. It's been a really cool experience. And William, Sean, Mike, and I would like to thank everybody, you know. And as we accept these awards, we want to remember our bandmates as well, Lane Staley and Mike Starr. And we got a couple of awards for their families as well. And wow, what a night.
Phil? I, Sean Kinney of Washington State, are bringing you this for Lane. I'm bringing you from MoPOP Mike's Founders Award.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Well, thank you. I thank you very much. And on behalf of Lane, I want to thank Alice and MoPOP for this prestigious award.
Congratulations. And Mike, this is for you.
Yes, it is.
And Lane and everybody. And
well, it's beautiful, and he'd be thrilled. And I am happy to have it displayed in my home on his behalf.
Mike would have drilled a hole in that and made a necklace.
I also want to say that I am truly blessed to be a part of the Alice family. Truly blessed.
They worked hard and make great music, and I wish Mike was here to get this himself, but I feel really proud of him.
Back when they first started in the late 80s, and they're still going, and it's wonderful. They're still good. Great music. Yeah.
And one thing I do know is that somewhere in this world, somebody for the first time is putting on Facelift and being blown away.
Wow.
Alice is truly eternal and evergreen. Thank you.
And when his stepbrother said, there's a band holding auditions, and you should go and try out, and they go, well, I'm not a singer. And his stepbrother said, let's just go try out. And of course, every kid in high school wanted to be a singer in a garage band, so they had lots of people to interview, but after they interviewed Lane, they said, nope, that's it, this is the one. He didn't consider himself a singer. He thought he was a drummer.
In the annual, mm-hmm. in high school at Highline, he said, I'm going to be a rock star and tour with Van Halen.
I'm going to open up my band's
going to
open
up for
Van
Halen. And that was how many years before he...
Only like, it was like within 5 years they did actually tour with Van Halen. Yeah. That's pretty cool.
He was focused. Thank you. Congratulations, cool. Alice. That's wonderful.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for MoPOP.